Today I am going to start lesson 7, more about scratch. So this scratch chapter you are going to study first time, you have not studied. So I am going to tell you about scratch. Now see, what is this scratch? Scratch is simply a computer language. Okay, it is nothing, it is a computer language. Because computer does not understand Hindi or English language. Okay, so if we have to give instruction to the computer or if we have to talk to the computer, then we have to learn some languages of computer. So one of them is Scratch. That is also a computer language. And these computer languages are also called programming language. Okay, another name of computer languages is programming language. So this Scratch, you can say Scratch is simply a programming language of computer. So this you are going to study about Scratch in this chapter. And this Scratch is very interesting and very beautiful. Like you have studied TuxPaint. In TuxPaint, what you do? In that different tools are there, like grass tool, flowers tool. You use different tools and you draw different drawing in this. But it is little different in Scratch. What you will get? You will get blocks. Okay, and what are these blocks? These blocks give instruction in the Scratch what computer had to do. So in Scratch we will use blocks. There are no tools, no options, or blocks are there. Okay, using these blocks we will give instruction to the computer. So Scratch is simply a programming languages. In higher classes you will learn more programming languages. So Scratch is very wonderful, very good programming language, and it is very simple also. In this nothing you have to do. What happens in Scratch? In Scratch simply you will see one sprite. Okay, this is the main component of Scratch. This sprite is simply a cat in Scratch. Okay, it is simply one cat. Okay, what is this sprite? Sprite is a cat in Scratch. What we do in Scratch, we give instruction to this cat. Okay, like we will give instruction for moving, so this cat will move. If we will give instruction for rotation, so this cat will rotate. So this sprite is there and we give instruction. And from where we give instruction, we use different blocks in Scratch. Okay. There are different kinds of blocks. We use these blocks and we give instruction to this sprite. And this sprite moves and does the work in our Scratch project. So now we will learn how it works. So first you see this much. Now there is in your book some features of Scratch are given. Scratch is given. You can see some features of Scratch is given. Like Scratch is available free, of course. Means you can download it in your computer or laptop. It is free. It is free. It is easy to understand and learn. It is very easy. Easily you can understand and learn Scratch. Okay, it's not very difficult. Like you download games and you play games in computer. You don't have to learn. You don't have to do any work. By your brain, you use your brain and you play the games. Same way Scratch is there. Okay, it's very simple, very interesting. Once you will start working on it, you will learn everything. Okay, it increases student interest in programming by providing the graphical user interface. So, it also increases students' interest in programming because Scratch is a programming language. So, it increases programming interest of the students. Instead of writing text code or predefined blocks are snapped together to create the script. Means in this we don't have to write anything, we don't have to do any work. We have to use blocks. Okay, so it's very simple. It does not need any extra work. Only predefined blocks are there. We use these blocks and we work in the Scratch. It also allows playful experimenting with the program. Means it's very interesting. It's playful. When you will work, you will feel good. When you will work on this Scratch. So this is the window of Scratch. When you will open Scratch on your computer, this window you will get. You can see in your book. Okay, you can see here one sprite is also given. This is your sprite. And where what it do? It moves here. Okay, it moves on this according to the instructions we give to the sprite. Now come to next page. See, next things I have given. Now first one is given sprite. Now what is this sprite? Okay, sprite. I have told it is simply one cat in the scratch. One cat is there. That is called sprite. Okay, sprite is known as a character. Okay, like you have seen different cartoon characters. So like this, sprite is also a character in scratch, and it works according to the instructions given. Okay, what instructions we give to this cat, according to that, this sprite will work. So this is called sprite. Now next one is stage. Now what is this stage? This stage is the area where sprite moves. Okay, the area where this sprite moves, or where this sprite lives, the area where this sprite lives, that area is called stage. As you can see in your book, okay, this, okay, this white color space you can see. So this is called stage. Okay, so where this sprite lives and moves. Okay, so this area is known as stage. Now one more thing. See, this stage, this horizontal part of the stage, this is called x coordinate. Okay, this is called x coordinate, and this vertical part of the stage, this is called y coordinate. This is your y coordinate. Okay, this horizontal part of the stage, this part, this is your x coordinate. This vertical part of the stage is your y coordinate, and it has some values like this 100, 200, 300, 400. Okay, here also like this values are given. Okay, so suppose our sprite is at this position. So using this x coordinate and y coordinate, we can find the position of the sprite. Suppose our sprite is present on this position of the stage. So see, what is the value of x here? 300. What is the value of y here? 400. So our x, y coordinate is 300, 400. So this is the position of our sprite. So using this x coordinate and y coordinate, we can also find the exact position of the sprite. Where our sprite is present. So this stage has this x and y coordinate. So using this, we can also find the position of this sprite. Now see next one. Next one is given sprite list. Now what is this sprite list? It is located below the stage and displays the thumbnails of all sprites that we have selected. See, this is your sprite list. You can see here. Okay, it is below the stage, and this tells which sprites we have used in our project. Okay, so this is given by this sprite list. Sprite list simply gives a list of the sprites that we have used in our project. Now, next one is blocks palette. Now what is this blocks palette? This blocks palette is simply nothing. You can see in your book. These blue color blocks you can see. So where these blocks are present, this area is known as blocks palette. You can see it is labeled here also. So where these blocks are present, so this area is called blocks palette. Now next one is script area. Now what is this script area? First I will tell you script. Script means the blocks which we have already used in our project. That is called script. Okay, script has at least more than two blocks. The blocks which we have used in our project, that is called script. And another name of script is program. Program is the another name of script. Now, what is this script area? The area where script is present, that is called script area. Like you can see in your book,
this is your script area. So suppose we are using blocks, suppose first blocks we have used. So what we will do, we will click on this first block and we will drag it and bring it here in the script area. As we will drag and bring in the script area, so this is called our script, and the area where these blocks are present, okay, this is called script area. So which blocks we have to use in a Scratch project, we drag it from here and we bring in the script area. So script area is simply an area which contains the blocks which we are using in our Scratch project. Now next one given in your book is Sprite Info Pane. Now what is this Sprite Info Pane? This Sprite Info Pane is simply one button like this. When we click on this button, it has three more buttons. Okay, it has three more buttons. One is, you can see in your book, circular arrow. This button is there. Okay, this is like this. One is linear arrow. This one is like this. And one is disable. Disable rotation. That is like this. So this script info pane is three buttons. Okay. Script info pane is like this. When we will click on this info pane, it will give you three buttons, linear, circular and disable. This circular button will rotate our sprite in any direction. This direction or this direction. That's why its name is circular. Using this circular button, we can rotate our sprite in any direction. Linear, you can see it is like this, this side and this side. So it rotate our sprite left or right position, means this side or that side. Means it rotates the sprite only left side and right side. And circular can rotate in any direction. Disable, this will stop the rotation. Means our sprite, if our sprite is at this position, it will remain at this position only. It will not rotate in any position. It will be remain in this position only. As our sprite is present, it will be in that same position, it will not rotate any side. That is known as disable. Stop. It stops the rotation of the sprite, and the sprite is present as it is. It will not rotate in any direction. So this sprite info pane contains three buttons for rotating the sprite. One is in circular direction, one is linear, and one is disable rotation. Now next thing that is given in your book, that is XY coordinate. XY coordinate, I have already told that this stage has two coordinates. This is your X coordinate, this is your Y coordinate, and using this XY coordinate, we can find the exact position of the sprite. Okay, at which position a sprite is present using these values. Like our value is 110 minus 110, like this. So this is also telling some position of the sprite. So using this, we can find the exact position of the sprite. And when a sprite is at first position, then x, y value is 0, 0. When x, y value is 0, 0, this means our sprite is at the starting position of the stage. Next one given in your book, that is direction. Now what is this direction? If the value is 0, it means the direction of the sprite is up. If the value is 90, the direction of the sprite is right side. If the value is 180, direction is downside. Okay, if the value is minus 90, direction is left side. So this values tells the direction of the sprite, in which direction our sprite is present on the stage. Okay, so all have understood this much. Now see next one given in your book, that is view full screen. Okay, this is simply a button, view full screen. Okay, like this one button you will get, view full screen button. When you will click on this button, this will open the Scratch on full screen of your computer. So this is the work of full screen. You can understand from the word only, full screen means it will come on full screen of your computer. Okay, next one is tabs. Now, what are these tabs? In Scratch, there are three kinds of tabs. One is script tab, one is costume tab, and one is sound tab. Okay, now what is this tabs? When you will click on script tab, this will show all the options related to script. When you will click on costume tab, this will show the options of costume. And when we click on sound tab, this will show the options of the sounds. So these three kinds of tabs are there. If we want to use script, we can click on script. Script tab will be open. If we want costume, we can click on costume. Costume tab will be open. So these are three kinds of tabs present in Scratch. Now next one is stage icon. Now what is this stage icon? This stage icon is also a simply button which is present near the sprite list. Okay, where the sprite list is present, I have told sprite list. It tells the list of the sprites which we have used. So this stage icon button is present there only. And using this stage icon button, we can get so many options related to stage. So this is simply the work of stage icon button. Now next one is cursor tools. It is also given in your book, cursor tools. This cursor tools has some buttons, like it has one duplicate button, which is given in your book, delete button, grow button, and shrink button. So these all buttons are used for sprite. This duplicate button will make the copy of the sprite. You can understand from word only, duplicate means how many copies of the sprite you want to make, you can make with this duplicate button. Delete button, what it do? By clicking on the option, will delete the selected sprite. This will delete your sprite. If you want to delete sprite, okay, so using this button you can delete your sprite. Grow button will increase the size of the sprite. Grow means growing. So this will increase the size of the sprite. And these all buttons you will get on cursor tools. Shrink button will decrease the size of the sprite. It will make your sprite small. Increase button will increase the size of the sprite. It will make your sprite big. And decrease button will decrease the size of the sprite. It will make your sprite small. So this much is given in your book. Now next topic which is given in your book, that I will show you on laptop. Okay, that is your practical work. That topics I will explain you on the laptop. I will show you how it works. And then I will explain the rest topic of this chapter. Okay, thank you class. Read your chapter. Read this book. Read this much, then watch the video. Okay, thank you.